lack of safe and effective sanitation affects about 40% of the world's population. So it's not just a public health crisis, which it is, but it's also a safety and dignity concern.
Feces is the main spreader of disease. So it's where all the bacteria is, and you want to get that out of the environment to help maintain health.
Our primary mission is to sort of leverage technology-enabled solutions to address global challenges in water sanitation and hygiene.
Collaboration is central to our strategic approach. At the center, we manage the sanitation technology cluster, which is a research and development portfolio comprised of about 25 partners in the water, sanitation, and hygiene sectors.
We realized early that if you're going to be effective at rapidly delivering solutions that had an impact on people in the field, you needed to pull in experts from other areas. Partners strengthen our ability to expedite the development of products for greater impact.
One of the things we've been working on for the last several years in this space is coming up with a means to treat wastewater that makes it safe for end users, but also that's affordable. So the Reclaimer is a liquid treatment system that we've developed in conjunction with MSR, with contributions from Cranfield University and Triangle Environmental. And it's designed to take black water, so water that includes human waste from toilets, and treat it through a sequence of steps. The Reclaimer does not require water to be pumped in. In fact, you can start with no water and just treat what comes out of the toilet. The benefit of not needing extra water is that you can greatly reduce the amount of water a household or a public toilet uses.
It's not a reinvented toilet so much as it is taking a waste processing plant that covers multiple acres and putting it in the size of a small room, in the size of a porta potty, for example.
Mal odor is one of the key obstacles to user adoption, and foul smelling toilets basically tend to push people to open defecate. So we are trying to understand how we can better control odor in order to improve user adoption.
The key in all of this is the probability of success that people will actually use the product that you put out there.
In order to more effectively introduce new technologies into the developing world, we had to understand the stakeholders involved. What are their cultural constraints? What are their economic constraints? And then what are the policy consequences and limitations and opportunities to introduce new technologies?
The ability of field testing is to provide very rapidly data about the longevity of the technology so that the inventors can iterate quickly on a more robust version that can become a product.
In addition to the Reclaimer prototype that we have in the lab, we have an identical sister Reclaimer out in the field at our site in India, in Coimbatore. So any improvements that we make in the lab, we can call them the next day and they can make small adjustments and changes.
Women and girls, besides being, you know, as you would expect, half of the population, so half of the users of any sanitation technology as well, women are also the decision makers in a family. And so if you, you know, enable a woman, you enable her whole family to achieve safe sanitation.
But the reason that I've become so excited about it is the social impact and the fact that we can improve health and the economy in developing regions.
A working toilet that processes the waste may seem like such a small thing, but it can have such a huge impact on your overall quality of life, which impacts then your mental health and your ability to really go forward in life and be successful. And that really drives me.